Hi everybody, my name is Sean Kim. I'm a solutions engineer for Snowflake based here in Sydney, Australia. And today I'm excited to show you a basic CI/CD pipeline using Terraform as a deployment tool, a GitHub for our code repository, and GitHub Actions for our CI/CD. So let's dive in. Now, before we dive into the code, I'd like to show you a quick diagram of what we'll cover in this video. So we've got a single Snowflake account with two environments, staging and production, each in it within its own database. Now we've got GitHub as a code repository and GitHub Actions, which will orchestrate our CI/CD workflows. Now, as a developer, we've got some Terraform code that's currently sitting in our main branch. Now we want to make some changes to this code, but instead of working directly on this branch, what we'll do is cut a branch called staging and we'll work on this branch instead. So we're not directly working on the master copy of the branch. We'll then make some changes, we'll commit the code and then push that into our remote repository, which will then kick off a GitHub Actions workflow. Now, within that workflow, it will run a series of Terraform commands and we will check for things like lintings, make sure it's all formatted nicely, validate our configurations, and then we'll essentially run a plan, which is kind of like a dry run, testing what we're changing against what's actually in our environment. So assuming that all runs correctly, it will then go and deploy Snowflake objects into our staging environment on our behalf. We'll take a look at the changes, and then once that's all looking good, we will then kick off what's called a pull request. This is where we'll bring in our reviewer. They'll take a look at the code, the changes, make some comments, provide feedback, etc. And then once that's all reviewed and approved, we'll then close the pull request and that will merge the changes we made in our staging branch into our main branch. So what will then happen from here is it will largely kick off the same process, run the same Terraform commands, but this time it is now going to deploy our Snowflake assets directly into the production environment. Now, all the code is available publicly on GitHub. You just go into, you just look for CI/CD Snowflake with Terraform demo, and you can see all the code in here, including all of our Terraform assets, as well as our GitHub Actions workflows. Now, if you're looking to run this demo locally, you will need to install Terraform on your machine. Now, if you head to developer.hashicorp.com/terraform/downloads, you'll see a set of instructions for installing Terraform on your operating system. Now, on my system, it's Mac OS, so we're using Homebrew to install Terraform onto my system. Okay, so let's dive into the code. So I've got VS Code open here, which is our IDE. This is all of our code we've got in our GitHub repository, and we've got a terminal open here, which we'll use as well. So this has all of our Terraform code. So I'll talk a little bit about how Terraform is set up here. So we've got one folder for each environment. So you've got one folder for production and one for staging. So now there's many ways you can do multiple environments within Terraform. This is my personal preference, where each subfolder is essentially its own Terraform project with its own configuration. I like that. I like it because it's a little bit more of a cleaner approach, but you can use things like workspaces or just variable substitution as well. They're all perfectly fine. Now, within each of these folders, this is where you declare your provider. So you've got Snowflake in here. We're using the Snowflake plugin for Terraform, which is currently managed by Snowflake Labs. Now, this is where you specify your backend as well. In this case, I've opted for S3. You can also use the Terraform Cloud software as a service, which will also manage the backend for you. And you can actually use the UI to do a lot of that management as well, which makes your life a little bit easier. But for here, I've just gone with a simple S3 configuration. So now it's where you provide your Snowflake details, the things like your username, the account, the role, and the private key. So here we never want to put in your password in code, especially one that you push to a GitHub Git repo. So we've opted for key pair authentication, where you attach a public key to a username and then we authenticate by supplying the private key. And I'll show you how GitHub Actions manages that in a moment. And then from here, this is where you call the modules, essentially a package that, you know, that bundles up all of the Terraform resources that you create. And then you can also specify any number of variables you can pass on into those within the module itself. So this is how you can sort of tweak settings or parameters between multiple environments. So in this example here, so you've got a time travel in days, a custom variable I've set to 30, whereas in a staging, I've set the time travel to 1, which makes sense, right? You want to give a longer time travel period for a production environment. Maybe you're not as worried as much about that within your staging environment. So within the module is where you, declare all of your variables and then all of our Snowflake resources. So nothing too complex here, just deploying databases, a schema, some grants to that database and schema, got some tables here as well as a compute cluster. But you can deploy almost every type of Snowflake object through this Terraform provider. So now, what we're going to do here is we're going to make just a really quick change to the code. I don't want to overcomplicate this. Just want to show you how and what that workflow looks like. So what I'm going to do is you can see from the terminal here, we're currently on the main branch. So what we're going to do is create a new branch and then we're going to jump into that new branch. So create checkout dash B. This B to say that we're going to create a new branch. And we're going to call that branch staging. So switch to a new branch called staging. And then now we can freely make changes to this code. So let's say in this particular example, let's just have a look at this warehouse configuration here, where you got the warehouse size, where if the environment name is prod, we'll give that a size of medium. Otherwise, we're going to give that an extra small. But let's say, for example, we've started processing a lot more data. We've started to see some performance degradation on a query. So we're going to bump up our compute instances. Let's give that a large now. And then let's say we're now testing on more and more data as well. We're going to bump up the non-prod environment as well. So we're going to give that a small. So from here, then you can run any number of Terraform commands, which we're going to get the CI/CD service to do for us. But I'll sort of show you what those commands are. So first of all, you've got Terraform FNT format, which is essentially your linter. So you can get this to either automatically format your code, white spaces and things like that, or you can run it as a check to essentially return an error code if it isn't formatted correctly. So it's a great way of enforcing code formatting standards within your CI/CD pipelines. Next up is you can run Terraform validate, which essentially just goes through your code, make sure all of your the configuration is correctly spelled. You've got the right data types in there, your references aren't funky, anything like that. And essentially, it's all of your checks before you actually start calling the remote service. So then we'll get to Terraform plan, which will essentially give you a transaction list of what you're going to change, or what you're going to change in the remote service. In this case, Snowflake. So now it's saying it wants to change the warehouse. It's going to change the warehouse size from a medium to large, which sounds good. Just realize this is actually in the production environment. So let's just actually change that to our staging folder, and we're going to do the same thing. So a Terraform plan, and this is actually going to give you a different result. And now it's saying it's going to add 9 resources. So everything that we've got in our module here, from the table to schemas, the grants, the databases, it's going to create all of that from scratch. Because what's happening here is I'll flip over to Snowflake for a moment. So you can actually see here that this is just this particular reader user. If you could look at the list of databases, you'll notice that this Terraform demo prod is in there, because when we ran Terraform plan from the prod folder, you can see that it didn't need to change much. That's because the objects already exist in that prod database, but it doesn't exist for our staging. So when we create this new staging environment, it's going to spin up a brand new environment for you. So switch back. So what you can actually do is call Terraform apply. Now, I'm not going to run this now. It should just confirm anyway. Actually, let's just run that anyway. So it should essentially give you that same plan list, and it asks me whether to confirm that action. I'm going to escape out of it, because we want to actually do that from our GitHub Actions. So Now, then we'll talk a little about GitHub Actions. So in the GitHub folder under workflows, you can see I've got two workflows set up here, one for production, one for staging. So we'll go into our staging configuration. So you can see that it's set up to run when there's a code push from only the staging branches. So really cool, because we created a staging branch. Any code that we commit and push into GitHub will automatically trigger this particular workflow. So in this workflow, we just run this single job. It'll then configure AWS credentials, as this is we are using S3 as our backend. It's going to go and configure that up. It's going to handle all of our secrets, and I'll show you how that works, like how GitHub Actions pulls down secrets and keeps that relatively secure. And it's going to run those commands I showed you earlier. So it's going to initialize Terraform projects, run format, validate, plan, and if that runs okay, it's going to then apply those changes onto Snowflake. So now from now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to commit and push that code into GitHub. Now I can just use the CLI here, or if you've got the extension on VS Code, you can do that too. There's some various user interface ways to handle Git, but here I'm just going to use a terminal here just for simplicity. So right, Git. I'm just going to call Git status just to see what's been what's changed, what needs to be added, etc. I'm going to commit the code in. We just got one file that needs to be that's been modified since I last changed it. So git commit, dash A to say all files, dash M to write a message. I'm going to say upsize compute warehouse. Right. And then I'll write git push, set upstream origin staging. So you just got these extra options whenever you create a new branch locally, and you got to push that into the remote version. So just going to do that. Great. So that's now pushed the code into a GitHub, and hopefully that should trigger the GitHub action workflow you can see here. So coming onto actions, let's have a look at our workflow, and you can see that with this message I sent, upsize compute warehouse, this is currently running. So while that's running, I'll sort of show you how the secrets work. So if you go into settings, if you go into secrets and variables, you see in actions, you can actually go and submit your secrets and to be handled by GitHub Actions. And when you actually use the secret GitHub Actions secrets action to pull secrets down, GitHub Actions won't store that secret in plain text, right? So because it produces logs and things like that, we don't want secrets being in plain text in that fashion, so it handles that for you. Optionally, you can also use a remote secrets manager service like AWS Secrets Manager or Parameter Store and services like that if you want that extra level of security. So coming back onto our actions tab, you can see that it's ran correctly. So let's take a quick look at what happened. So it's, you go into each of these workflows and you can see each step of what was run and what's the essentially the output of that of that particular command. So it's run all the Git Terraform init. That's all looking good. It's passed the format check. It's passed the validate check. It's run a plan. So notice that because this is on that staging environment, so there was nothing created. So it's gone and created since all nine of the resources, and it's gone and run Terraform apply here as well. So that's all, it looks like it's all being created successfully. Yep, apply complete, resources 9 added. So we can, let's go over into Snowflake. We should be able to see a new copy. There we go. So we now see the staging database is now active on our Snowflake account. So I can do, again, this setup is quite simple, just a database, a schema, and a single empty table, right? So now what we're going to do is we're going to create a pull request. So this all looks good. Of course, if you've got something more complex, you might run unit tests, you might run integration tests, make sure all the components are working correctly. You might do regression tests to make sure it's not breaking functionality, etc. But this is a very simple example. So let's just go straight into a pull request. So I'm going to write a pull request here. Let's create a new pull request. And then let's get the staging. And let's say we're going to create a pull request based on these changes here. So you can already see it's quite simple. It's only a one line change with just changing the compute warehouse sizes. So I'm going to create a pull request here. Now leave a comment, upsize compute warehouse. So I'm going to create a pull request. And then I can actually add reviewers here. So now I've just got, this is just my other GitHub account. Usually you might restrict pull requests so that, you know, you might need multiple reviewers to give it a tick before approving the pull request. So you need multiple, you know, people to look at it. But here, I don't have anyone here with me, so I'm just going to add this, reviewer here, which is just myself. I'll get an email saying that, this user has requested a pull request from you. So imagine I'm the reviewer for a second. What you'll do is you'll go then, you know, have a look at the commits. Let's have a look. Yeah. Oh, see the repository. See, you can see the details about each of the commits. You can see the different checks that happen. So this is where you can see the what we call the actions workflows that ran from that particular branch, and you can see the list of files that have been changed here. So again, it's just a simple change. Now, well, one custom action that this did is we ran some custom code that got GitHub Actions to essentially spit out those Terraform commands, the outputs of the Terraform commands, I should say, in a message. So in a single glance, we can actually see ahead of time for every reviewer to see, you know, what's going to change here. So you notice this actually ran Terraform validate and plan for the production environment. So you notice it only ran up to the staging environment when we created the staging, but when we created the pull request, we actually got the workflow to run this script, which essentially outputs kind of what the changes are going to be on the production environment in this message here. So it's really handy. Feel free to use this for your other Terraform projects. I thought it's a really neat addition to Terraform projects on GitHub. So you can see that at a glance. Now, if pending reviewer, you could then go in and review it, but I'm just going to go ahead and merge the pull request. So let's merge that in, confirm the merge. Now you can delete the branch here as well. I usually like to do that, so I just go ahead and delete it. And then let's head over into actions, and that should actually trigger off the production, the production workflow. So it's, like I mentioned, it's the same workflow, except it's now going into our production environment. So go into our pull request, and you can see that running here. So just running all that there. Great. It's just going to change that warehouse size from medium to large. Great. That's all looking good. Excellent. So we can now go over to our Snowflake account. What we changed was the warehouse. So what we'll do is go into admin. We'll see our warehouses. You'll notice that this particular one, the HOL task warehouse, has now been changed into large. Yep, there we go. It used to be a medium. Now it's been changed into a large. And that's it. I hope you found this video useful. This is more of a quick demo. I'm showing you more or less the workflow, but if you'd like to go a little bit more in depth into CI/CD topics or on Terraform or on the Snowflake integration, please let us know in the comments, and we'll look into providing that for you as well. So thank you.